Now we are going to see about types of inflorescence. Topic: racemose inflorescence. The racemose means the central axis of the inflorescence, the pedangle. The central axis of the inflorescence and the pedangle. Pedangle means the stalk of the inflorescence. The possesses the terminal bud which is capable of growing continuously and produce the lateral flowers is called a racemose inflorescence. The lateral flowers the produced is called a racemose inflorescence. Then arrangement of flowers: the old flower at the base and young flower towards the apex. The old flower at the base and young flower towards the apex is called a racemose inflorescence. Then the racemose inflorescence the further divided into three types based on growth pattern of main axis. Then racemose inflorescence, then three types: main axis elongated, the main axis shortened, and the main axis the flattened or globose. The main axis elongated divided into six types. First one the simple raceme, second one spike, third one catkin, fourth one spikelet, spadix, one more is panicle. Next one main type, the main axis shortened divided into two types: corymb and umbel. Next one the main axis flattened or globose, division divided into head. Then main axis elongated. Main axis elongated, the first one simple raceme. The main axis elongated definition: the axis of inflorescence. The axis of inflorescence is elongated and contains pedicellate or sessile flowers. The pedicellate or sessile flowers means the pedicellate, the absence of the pedicel. The absence of pedicel is called pedicellate. Then the following types are discussed under the main types: elongated, simple raceme, spike, spikelet, catkin, spadix, and panicle. First one, the simple raceme. Simple raceme, the inflorescence with an unbranched. In the inflorescence with an unbranched main axis, which bears the pedicellate flower. The with flowers, the pedicellate flowers in acropetal succession. For example, Crotalaria retusa, mustard, and radish. Second one, main axis elongated types, the spike. The spike example, Agiranthus. The spike means the spike is an unbranched indeterminate inflorescence. Indeterminate means limited growth of tip. Then sessile flower, this one the sessile flower. The sessile means the absence of pedicel, absence of stalk of the flower is called sessile flowers. For example, Agiranthus. Then second one type, the spikelet. Second one type, the spikelet. Example, Paddy. The spikelet, the inflorescence is with branched central axis. This Paddy alapino, the branched central axis. The branched central axis, the each branch is spikelet. Then sessile flowers are formed in acropetal succession. The central flowers are formed in acropetal succession and the axis. Then tepals reduced to colorless scaly leaves. The tepals means the undifferentiated calyx and corolla is called tepals. The Paddy, tepals reduced to colorless scaly leaves. Then tepals, the most of the plant present in monocotyledons plants: Paddy, wheat, barley, sorghum, etc. Then each flower has stamen and pistil only. Stamens mean the male sex organ and pistil means the female sex organ present in the each flower. For example, Paddy. Then next one, subdivision, catkin. The catkin are, for example, Prosopis julifera. The catkin example, Prosopis julifera. The common name, Karubelamaram. The pendulous spike, this one, the spendulous spike with a long and drooping axis bearing the small flower. The bearing small unisexual or bisexual flower. Unisexuals mean male and female sex organ present in the separate flowers is called unisexual. Bisexuals means the male and female sex organ present in the same flower. For example, hibiscus. Then, catkin example, the Prosopis julifera and Piper nigrum. Then, another one type of main axis elongated spadix. The spadix, the inflorescence with a fleshy, fleshy and thick and central axis that possesses many unisexual flowers, sessile flowers and acrobatal succession. Usually female flowers are found towards the base, at male flowers are found at the apex. The male flowers are found at the apex. For example, the coconut and colocasia. Then another one type, the panicle. For example, Mangifera indica. A branched racemic is called panicle. For example, Mangifera, neem, etc. It is also called a compound raceme or raceme of racemes. This is also called the compound raceme. For example, Mangifera, the branched raceme present in the panicle type of inflorescence. The branched raceme is called the panicle type. For example, Mangifera indica, neem, etc. Then next types. Main axis shortened. Main axis shortened divided into two types, corymb and umbel. Corymb example Caecil pinnae and umbel example the Allium sepa. First one, corymb. The main axis shortened. The inflorescence with reduced. This inflorescence with reduced growth of central axis. There are divided into two types. First one, now see about corymb. Corymb means an inflorescence with shorter pedicellate. The inflorescence with a shorter pedicellate at the top. This pedicellate on the top and the longer pedicellate flowers at the bottom. The shorter at the apex, the longer at the bottom. All the flowers appear at the same level. All the flowers appear at the same level to form convex or flat top racemose inflorescence. For example, Caecil pinnae pulcherrima. Then the compound, the corymb example cauliflower. A branched corymb is called a compound corymb. For example, cauliflower. Then second one type, umbel. Umbel example Allium sepa. Allium sepa common name onion. The Tachys carota common name carrot. The Allium sepa, an inflorescence with indeterminate central axis. The inflorescence with indeterminate central axis and pedicellate flowers arise from a common point. The common point of peduncle at the apex. The peduncles means the stalk of the inflorescence. For example, Allium sepa, Centella asiatica. Centella asiatica common name vallarai. Second one, the compound umbel. For example, Tachys carota. The compound umbel, a branched umbel. This is a branched umbel. Each smaller unit is called umbellule. For example, Tachys carota, Coriandrum sativum, etc. Then third one, main type, main axis flattened. The divided into type head. The head is a characteristic inflorescence of Asteraceae and is also found in some members of Rubiaceae. Then, for example, Mimosa pudica, the common name, the sensitive plant. The present in the Fabaceae family. The Mimosapidae present in the Fabaceae family. Then the head divided into two types. The homochamous head and heterochamous head. First, now see about homochamous head. Homochamous head. This type of inflorescence. This type of inflorescence exhibit homochamous means single. This homochamous the exhibit single kind of floret. Only one present in the only one type of floret present in the homochamous head. For example, Vernonia. The example Vernonia. This Vernonia flower present in the ray floret only present in Vernonia. Second one, another one type, the ray floret. The ray floret present in the ray floret present in this type. The ray, for example, the Sonchus. The ray floret, the Sonchus present in the homozygous. Either present in ray floret or disc floret present in the homochamous head. Second one type, the heterochamous head. Heterochamous means, hetero means two. The two floret present in the flowers. For main example, the Caelianthus. Caelianthus, the sunflower. The heterochamous head, the inflorescence possesses both type of floret. Both type of florets, ray floret and disc floret present in the flower. Same flower. The Caelianthus, Tridax, etc. The disc floret, the present in the center of the head. The disc floret, the present center of the head at the tubular. And bisexual. Bisexual means already I told, bisexual means male and female sex organ present in the same flower. For example, hibiscus. The bisexuals, where is the ray floret? The ray floret are found at the margin of the head, which are ligulate, fistulate. The example, the unisexual. Main example of the Caelianthus. That's all.